That was an interesting preview. You guys wonder if the Time Masters will go after them this episode? I can't feel my face. At least they're admitting that it's going to be a cheesy episode with the camera shots and the League of Assassins girl whipping out her gun and spinning it around, twirling it in her finger, and the slow motion shots, and the Adam being a Western aficionado. Yeah, let's make it some bullshitty canon, why not? Yeah, Captain Cold can wear that cowboy hat. There's a perfect reason as to why they need to go through the Wild West now. I totally believe this. There was a lot of action. Of course, Captain Cold shot somebody after old dude Firestorm probably cheated at a card game, revealing his background and how they don't have to have the fate of repeating what the father did, even though he did cheat at the card game. So think about that. Hawk Girl and Heat Wave, I believe, or some other dude that Captain Cold beats up, challenges each other to a game of drinking. They sort of did a Doc Brown thing with old Firestorm dude, having him be like Doc Brown and Clara in Back to the Future Part 3. was revealed Rip Hunter. It was revealed Rip Hunter had some connections to that town, which is why he didn't show up. And now Hot Girl and League of Assassins Lady is being held up. they discuss Carter and whether Shiera should like other men, because this lady in the Wild West finally recalls her past lives. If Shiera doesn't recall her, and the old lady Shiera remembers that she couldn't go on after Carter was killed early in this life, make them have to wait a while before. Yes, this is very poorly told, so we're being tired, but you know, well, there's some cowboy action now. This brings the dilemma of Shiera not ever being satisfied. Although they did mention in the previous episode that she never met Adam before. During this episode, I just like to mention that it does seem sort of superficial that they would bring this old lady. It's cool that they brought the old lady to encounter Shiera, but like they already brought up the last episode that Shiera never been to Adam before in her lifetimes. In addition to how the old lady's revelation that of her opinion of the previous lives isn't. It's very thinly written, as brought up so late in the episode. Unless this is a two-parter, which I didn't look up, like it sort of doesn't have a point to it. So Rip Predator basically does a whole bunch of bullshit. Shoot somebody, probably the guy who was left over or something. It's 2.1 seconds in the Islanders Florida Panthers game. First period. 2-2 tie. Last time I checked, Washington Capitals were up 1-0 versus Philadelphia Flyers. Washington has a really good record. I would recommend for coach of the year. End of the first. So, of course, the friggin' time masters find them, and then they try and go after them. Commercial break. Spends 10 minutes. What is this episode about, really? They don't talk with the grand lady, Firestorm, anymore. How long is this two-parter? I'll see. Should be back now. Is there even 4 minutes? Commercials. Are they back? Yep, the Time Hunters are finding them. So the flying devices are occurring. Closing for really cool camera effects. Hot girl. Well, this is a really cool fast motion thing. Firestorm, bitches! These Time Hunter people don't really look that threatening. Especially considering that one of them is resurrected, and one of them is just a person with human weapons. Well, that was the Atom who was doing the flying stuff. That was pretty cool. That was a lot better than the last few episodes, which is relieving. We gotta look to see what. Also, why Jonah Hex in the episode when he could have done. I mean, that's also the problem with the Legends of Tomorrow episodes, like, they always got to balance the amount of characters they use and who they emphasize. Even though it's an hour, which they do a pretty good job at it normally. However, this is a sort of a joke of an episode anyway. It's still pretty enjoyable. They couldn't part anymore with H.G. Wells in Back to the Future Part 3. Not to mention there's also Harrison Wells in Flash 2. Flash season, whatever. Flash and Harrison Wells, you know. You know what I'm talking about. And now the Time Masters have sent the Pilgrim after them, going after their younger selves before they can be able to fight back. And it's very dramatic. Even with Adam says, come over here, we'll live. And then they have to all figure out how to get to their younger selves without... by finding out which time. In addition to which person, etc. People can disappear from the timeline as a result. Among other things. The Shiera storyline seems a little bit superficial again because... well... is there a TV show like romance thing? Like, what was the crush? How do they really know if it's going to be a permanent thing? I don't know if the Adam and Hakko's connection is that strong that we wouldn't believe that they would actually be stopped seeing each other and stuff. This whole plot of Rapunzel's past character and people in the West and saving people and stuff. Sure, bullshitty. I wish there was more about Old Man Firestorm and saving the lady. But that doesn't really go anywhere, and they don't really use Young Firestorm at all. Link of Assassin's Lady wasn't really done used for anything except to help. Let's use bring the ladies in one scene, or keep the two ladies in one scene together, or very campy. There really wasn't a lot to this episode, and sort of joke episode. Hope you enjoyed.